Is it okay? When Prashant offered to me to be one of the speakers at the StoryYellers, I was very excited. And I thought it's going to be very easy for me. I've been writing plays and stories and poems. What is it, writing a story about myself? Seeing the truth about myself, speaking about myself. But then, when I decided to write my speech 2 days ago, my brain was paralyzed. My pen, who normally listened to me, just stopped. Just would not listen. Just stopped to write a word. And then normally people think of me as a very good speaker. Now you see I'm not. Reason being, I always clung on to three P's. Practice, podium, and paper support. Now this format does not allow podium to camouflage my shaking legs or paper support, and practice, I had no time for it. The whole of last month, my mother-in-law was here. How many of you have mothers-in-law? It's not easy. The whole of last month, my mother-in-law was here, and all I did was three C's: cleaning, cooking, and complaining. Anyway, but I had to write. It was the 11th hour. Day before yesterday, I sat to write what I wanted to say. And the whole journey of 52 years of being on this planet swam before my eyes. Born in 1965, to a 16-year-old girl and a 20-year-old boy who was still in the final year of college. I was here because they did not know how to stop me from being here. So naive were my parents. And they were very unhappy when I was born for three reasons. One, I was unwanted, absolutely uninvited. Two, because I was a girl. And three, because I was not fair. But even after having me, they still hadn't learned how to stop a child from coming into their life. So 1.5 years after me followed my sister. Now they were again unhappy, but now for two reasons. One, because she was a girl. And two, again she was uninvited and unwanted. But they were very happy for one reason. She was fair and lovely. My granny always said, when I was born, everybody I know has told me that my granny was very upset. She would look at me and say, "Uff, ek to ladki, upar se kali. Mere baite bahu itne gore hain, lagta hai doodh wala jo kalu ram aata hai uski chhaya pad gaya." Now, thanks guys. Actually, I mean, which scientist in the world who claims to have total mastery over the DNA and the genes or whatever would understand this theory? But my granny said it with total conviction. So this Kali stayed on with me. So what happened? A very painful thing with my childhood. Now I might cry. It's good I can't see you. Okay. So ever since I was 5 or 6, my mom would religiously make a paste of sandalwood and turmeric and apply it on my face, hoping and praying that my skin would lighten and would be close to my siblings. But no, okay, my third sibling came in 5 years later because my parents had learned how to stop having a child and have one when they wanted to. So, they had two very fair children and one not so fair child. So they were very embarrassed. So, now started, I had a whole panel of advisors right from the time I was 6. So my mom would apply this, and the auntie from the neighborhood, anybody, just about anybody, "This doesn't work anymore. Besan dahi try kijiye." Whatever. We would go shopping twice a year for clothes. Things were very different back then. 45 years ago, things were different. Two trips to buy clothes, Holi and Diwali. What would happen was, on these trips, we had an ambassador car. My mom, her Devrani, my aunt, and 6 kids would be stuffed into that car. 8 of us, and the 9th one would be the driver. And we would go to our favorite stores. Very few stores sold ready-made clothes, actually. For all the other children, they were allowed to choose their clothes. But for me, no. If I chose a yellow, they would say, "Hat, kali pe kahan yellow achha lagega? No, no, no. Brown, tere rang ke saath mil jayega, Pinky." I would wonder why they named me Pinky and not Brownie. It was sad. It sounds funny now, but it was heart-wrenching at that point. A part of my soul always broke away. And I would just sob, excuse myself, and run into the car and sit there. And the driver always asked, "Kya hua baby? I would say पेट दुख रहा है. एनी वे वेन आई वॉज 19 माई फादर वॉज गोइंग थ्रू टेरिबल फिनेंशियल क्राइसिस एंड आई वॉज ऑफ मैरिज विलेज एट 19 एट बैक देन यू वर ऑफ मैरिज विलेज एंड फ्रॉम द कम्युनिटी आई बिलोंग टू एंड वन हिज डॉटर वॉज नॉट प्रिटी एंड टुडे टू ही हैड नो डाउरी सो ही वॉज वरिड एंड वर्ल्ड अराउंड वॉज वरिड हाउ वुड ही गेट हिज डॉटर मैरिड ऑफ. Then came this proposal from Raj Biraj. How many of you have heard of Raj Biraj in Nepal? See, you haven't. How do you think I would have heard of it? Anyway, this big zamindari family from Raj Biraj has sent a proposal. A meeting was fixed. I met my husband, the man I was going to marry, in Victoria Memorial in Calcutta. You know Victoria Memorial, Calcutta? No? Victoria Memorial, Calcutta? So there's a big Gulmohar tree. I still remember that. And we were both standing there. We're supposed to meet and decide our life in 17 minutes. That's how it was then. And the first 7 minutes, we introduced ourselves. Introduce Manikya. Name, hobbies, number of siblings, education. That's it. 5 minutes of total silence, uncomfortable silence. I almost made a hole in the ground with the nose, with my toes. But anyways, and then my parents and his parents signaled us, time up, come off. And then when we were just parting, he said, ki, though I'm from a little town in Nepal, but I've always dreamt of marrying a girl, a city girl, who's convent educated and who's pretty. I was sure he was lying. And I want to marry you and I promise I'll keep you like a princess. I was sure he was lying. But the fact that he wanted to marry me and they did not want dowry, I agreed. And I actually wanted to unburden my dad. So I agreed to marry him. And we did. Now, I came to Raj Biraj. Raj Biraj coming to Raj Biraj was not another country. It was like another planet. It was like I was living with aliens. You know, it was nothing like the people I grew up with, nothing like the place I was in. And before I got married, people knew it's a little small town, a village. And so all my bhabis, it's a big family, I was brought up in a nuclear family, all my bhabis, God has sent this advisory panel with me, you know. Somehow people had to advise me, as soon as they saw me, you know, that they just had to say something, they had to give me some tips, some advice. I don't know, it was just there in my kundali, I think, you know. So what happened? So these bhabis, this bhabi of mine, I'll never forgive her till I die, she's on constant war with her mother-in-law. She hates her husband, but she gave me 3,000 tips on how to be a good wife and a good bahu. I said, okay. And so, you know, I had no dreams of a good of a marriage. You know, normally girls dream, they have such suhane sapne, but I only had fears and apprehensions. And then when I came to Raj Biraj, of course, I had a panel of advisors here too. There was a domestic help. This lady would come with bed tea and on a platter, tips and advice. And it was all, you know, she would hear things from the family and she would all come and then she would sit down there and she would say, Tabai go amale kehi sikhaya chhe na? Roti sama pakauna aundai na? Kosto. Ani ke tha chhe na? Buari lagi yaha sama ghumte rakhnu parcha? Ye tabai la to kehi tha chhe na? And she would go. I would begin my, there would always be two or three tears in my cup of tea. And that was not enough. My husband had this little nephew, 7-year-old. And he would say, Chachi, aap kuch nahi jaante hain. Aapko pata hai, dadi maa ke saamne chacha se baat karna kitna ganda lagta hai. Oh my God, what kind of world was this? And he would give me all kind of advice, chacha se baat mat karo, English to bilkul mat bolo. Sabko lag raha aap dhaag dikha rahe hain. And that was the way we would speak. I could not speak. If I have to speak 7 lines just in Hindi or just in English, I'd get uncomfortable. That's the way we are brought up. So I would feel so sad. And the thing is, the fact is, and the saddest thing is, my husband was showering with me with all his love, affection. He was trying to keep me like a princess. That all just did not matter. All I would think about is the criticism, the advisory committee, which God had planned for me at every point of my life. 5 years down, my husband realized I would probably die in Raj Biraj. So he got me to Kathmandu. I love Kathmandu. This is my city of joy. That was one turning point in my life. Kathmandu, this was the first time I got lucky in life, I think. People somehow heard, they got to know that I could write and I had a creative streak. And that was a time there was a lot to be done in Kathmandu. Now there are a lot of people who write, who do a lot of things. But 25 years back, so I got a lot of attention. My creativity was acknowledged. So I used to write plays. I used to, for our community, the Marwari Samaj, we used to organize little cultural shows. I used to write the plays. I used to write for people's sangeets and for silver jubilees and golden jubilees. And I had become a celebrity in my own right. But then that wasn't enough. You know, I felt my creativity was being suppressed. You know, I had very limited. I wanted a bigger sky to fly. I wasn't getting, you know what, doesn't sound nice, but I always use this term. I wasn't getting that creative orgasm, you know? It sounds a little crass. I hope there are no kids around. So it's a good thing I can see nothing. So I think my son is in the car. Oh my God. Shivam, you're 22. It doesn't matter, maybe. So anyways, then I started this theatre company called Pink and Grey Unlimited. One day, finally, I just said, okay, I'll do a play. I wrote this play, found a few friends whom I said, I'll teach you how to act, and booked a hall and all of that. And 1 month, 17 days, I staged my first play, Asman Ke Us Paar. And it was the biggest hit. I mean, it was amazing. 400 seats I had sold and people were talking about it. People still talk about it. It was extraordinary. It was dreamlike. But then I was extremely happy. I was on cloud nine. But this happiness was not to stay. Because with me, with my horoscope, was this advisory committee. So this man, I thought I want to name him, but okay, I will not, okay? This gentleman, who stays just across the road, he had come for the play, he had obliged me by buying a ticket. He came in and said, Bhabhi ji, play to achha hi na kiye the. This was a scene, this was set in Yamlok. You know what is Yamlok? Okay, Yamlok mein tha, bahut hi achha laga. Yamraj to kya majedar tha. Par ka tha, aap jo Yamraj rakhe, uska sawari kahi nahi rakhe? Yamraj ka sawari, you know who is Yamraj ka sawari? Bhains. I was blabbering, I didn't know what to say. Maja nahi aaya. Wo aata na hota na, tab sach mein maja aata. After he had left, I said, I don't know a bhains who is toilet trained. I don't know where you find a diaper to fit a bhains. Anyway, but the sad thing is, 399 people said it was amazing. This one man, with his baseless opinion, his baseless comment, took away all my happiness. My whole, so I used to feel, I mean, nothing seemed important anymore. All I would remember is what he said. And I felt like a loser. That happened with all my plays. I always sold 400 tickets, 500 tickets, and people always loved my plays. But there would always be five people whom God was sent. And they would have something to say, and all my happiness would evaporate. It would all go zoom out the window. That was sad. But it's not only my plays. Whenever I would go into a party, see, I know I'm fat. I know I'm not fair. I have a mirror and a weighing scale at home. Do I need to be told all the time? Damn. Every time I go to a party, I do everything to camouflage my, whatever, I think I'm okay. But, and even I wear a lot of good makeup, I buy the most expensive makeup, but every time I, and my husband says, wow, maal lag rahi hai. He's there, I love you for this. So he's there, he's right there. So, but when I enter a party, there'll always be two or three people who'll say, aur moti ho gayi na? Damn you. Somebody will say, dekho Archana, it's not only about weight. Dekh, shakal wakal se koi farak nahi padta apni age mein. It's, you know, diabetes, blood sugar, I have it all. Diabetes, blood sugar, ye wo sab ho jata. Shut up, you freak. And don't even go to this dessert counter. Dekhna bhi mat udhar. And you know, I just just want to cry. I've come back so depressed. I want to just shoot her and tell her, slap her and tell her, hey, listen, 40, 50 pounds is not a big deal. I can lose it. But what about you? This is empty. You can't inject gray cells, can you? You dumbo. What about your nose? It looks as if a car has run over it. But see, I come back feeling really upset. Every area, people advise. Every area of my life, damn it. Now, my son just got married. I have an amazing daughter-in-law. You go to a party, kaisi hai bahu? Bahut achhi hai. Arey, abhi achhi lagti hai. Keep her under your thumb. Koi bahu beti nahi ban sakti, na saas maa ban sakti. Be sure, you keep her under your thumb. Another will say, hey, nahi, bahut pyar se rakho. Beti aur bahu mein kya fark hai? I'm so confused. I feel like an idiot. So, about an year ago, this feeling of an idiot is not a nice feeling, it's not a happy feeling. I was actually upset. And I was very low on self-esteem. I needed help. I went to counselors, I went to psychiatrists. But then and then menopause added to the pain. So I went to Art of Living. Art of Living, the first day, the first session, the teacher said, don't be a football of other people's opinion. I said, oh my God, I not only look like one, I feel like one. And then what happened really changed everything within me. There was this woman, we had to introduce ourselves. So obviously, we all had, say, 5 minutes to say something about ourselves. And I said, I didn't have much good to say about my life. I said, whatever. And then the last lady who spoke, Shakuntala ji, a 65-year-old woman. Hold your breath. What she said was, she was 65. She was born and brought up in a brothel. A brothel, have you heard it? Her mother was a prostitute and she had been one too. And she had two children from a profession. She did not know their fathers. And then she, after the children, the girls were growing up, she moved out of there and she said, then I worked from home. Are you understanding? She worked from home. She left a brothel. Then probably she was a call girl. She worked from home. And she educated her girls. Now, she has enough money to live a comfortable life. And one of her daughters is a lecturer in Chandigarh and one in the US is a doctor. And she has 4 or 5 grandchildren and she's very happy. There was silence, just like this, worse than this. Like the sound of the silence was deafening. People, I'm sure, could not breathe. But she lived very comfortably. And we went to the dining room for our lunch. She was sitting there, and there were 6, 7 of us there with her. People were, hush-hushing about her. She was eating coolly, as if nothing had happened. And these people were talking about her, and then one of them gathered courage and said, Suniye, aap mazduri kar lete, kuch bhi karte, apne bachchon ko palte, itna ganda kaam kyun kiya aapne? Another quipped in, ऐसा कीजिए आप ना आपने जो किया किया अब ऋषिकेश में रहिए टेक अ डिप इन द गैंजेस एवरी डे टू क्लेंज योर सोल देन वन मोर सेड कि यू नो इट्स बिकॉज ऑफ विमेन लाइक यू दैट थाउजेंड्स ऑफ होम्स आर ब्रोकन दैट्स व्हाई मेन स्ट्रे नाउ दैट वाज इट शकुंतला जी जस्ट स्टूड अप बैंग द टेबल एंड सेड नाउ दिस माइट साउंड टू क्रास I'll be nothing close to her because she started with a string of abuses. You know those Punjabi abuses, maaki banki type? And then she said, hey, ucha, khusur pusur kab se laga rakhi hai? Mujhe pata tha mere baare mein baat kar rahi hai. Par pata hai, jab haathi chalta to kutte bhaunkte, mujhe koi fark nahi padta. Ek baat bata dun, kis izzat ki baat kar rahi ho tum log? Haan? Kis paap punya ki baat kar rahi ho? Tu ja ke dubki laga ganga mein. गंगा में शरीर नहीं आत्मा साफ होती और मेरी आत्मा गंगा से भी साफ है और मुझ जैसी औरतों की वजह से नहीं तुम्हारे पति बिगड़ते हैं तुम्हारी वजह से तुम ना प्यार दे पाते हो ना सम्मान तब वो आते हमें चाटने इट वॉज क्रास इट वॉज चीप एंड देन शी सेड कि मेरी जिंदगी में सिर्फ जो मेरे सफ़र के हम सफ़र हैं द पीपल हु हैव लिव द जर्नी विथ मी सिर्फ उनको हक है मुझे कुछ बोलने का और मैं उन्हीं की बात सुनती हूँ बाकी सब बातें आवाजें हैं शब्द नहीं हैं आई एंड शी और चल हट खाना खाने दे चुपचाप फटो ऐसे हवा आने दो I stood up and clapped. I was amazed at her. And that was the point. That was the point I realized. That's what I want to do with my life. I went back. I was in my room. I slept. I could not sleep for a bit. I kept up all night. And I made a train. The journey. Now listen to this and take this home. I made a train. How many of you have traveled in a train? We don't have railways in Nepal. So the first compartment, the first bogey, it has a few bogies. So the first bogey and the first compartment, I was there with the five people I love most, my husband and my three children. They were there. The next compartment, my parents, my siblings, and so on and so forth. The next bogies, everybody else I knew. I filled up everybody else. So the people traveling with me in my compartment or the compartment next to me, what they said about me, their opinion, their thoughts, their feelings, only that matter. Everything else is just sounds, not words. Thank you, Shakuntala ji, you changed my life. It's not that I still go to parties and I'm saying, kya ho gaya Archana, kyun nahi samajhti ho, moti bahut ho gayi ho. Now, I don't care, they're just sounds, not words. They can look at my face. It's all written, shut up, you jerk. Cut the crap. F off. Thank you.